Hey guys, I'm a few minutes late. I had to set up my camera again because I put it away and it took a little bit longer than I expected. I'm gonna work today again on the challenge that I've been working on for the last few days. If you don't know it, I made a YouTube video about it where I explain it, but it's basically where I do a study first and then I draw a design, and I do that 50 times. Let me check, Tom, is the audio okay on YouTube? Because my sound settings are showing warning signs or something. Like my microphone. I think my desktop, the audio is doing well.
Yeah, it's a little loud, your voice.
Alright, let me check.
Where it's like peaking.
Okay, I put it a little bit softer now, but it seems to be still peaking. How about this? Is this better? Or is it too soft, maybe? The audio is always like a difficult thing to get right, I think.
It's better now. But leave it like this.
Alright. And also the music is fine.
Yeah, you could put it a little lower.
Little lower, alright. I put the song on that I wanted to listen to, and then I clicked it away. Classic. Let's get my Pinterest board. If you wanna follow along with the Pinterest board that I made, you can find it in the description. And you can also make, of course, your own Pinterest board with whatever subject you want to practice. I'm practicing dogs, and every time I do a study first and then I draw a creative design to try and build the fundamentals, but also be creative at the same time. Let me see. I already did one study, like I did this yesterday evening, but this is the one of the studies that I had to do today. So I think I'm gonna start with a creative one. Yeah. And I was planning to do some little rectangular pieces again, because I really like that on this page. Let me see. This is here, and I really like those, so I wanted to do something similar.
It's gonna be so empty after the last one.
Yeah, definitely. Because this was the last one and I feel I just crammed this as full as I can. Maybe I could do something here and here, and then it would be totally full. But this is going to be more a simplistic page, I think. I'm gonna grab some middle level watercolor paper. Like, it's not the most expensive I have, but it's also not the cheapest. It's pretty good paper. I want to give it some nice edges by actually tearing it instead of cutting it. I'm using this little metal box to fold it. Like some pressure. This actually holds the supplies that I want to work with today. I grabbed some handmade watercolors and handmade brush. I think I'm gonna use those today. I haven't used my handmade paints in a while and I want to give them some more love. They are created by all kinds of people that I like, that I talk to, and I want to use their supplies. I always love it when people use my ceramic palettes. But they also love it when people use their supplies.
I think they're gonna watch the video because they know you use their stuff.
Well, I didn't tell them. But they'll definitely, like, if I post it on Instagram, they'll give me a like at least. Watching a live stream is a bigger commitment of time.
Yeah, definitely.
I did post on Instagram this time that I'm gonna live stream, but it's in my stories. And I put like 8 stories about the new palettes before then, so I don't know if a lot of people will see it. Maybe some like people will join.
Like the homeowners association.
Yeah, like they're putting. Yeah, you have to fill in this document, but we're gonna hide it on the 16th edit document of the email on the third page.
I am live streaming. How did you not know? I put it in my 16th Instagram story.
Yeah, what the hell? How didn't you know? But we'll have to build it up, like I want to slowly build up the announcements too. I now try to put them on YouTube at least a couple of hours ahead every time. And, I'll try to put them on Instagram, but yeah. Something I have to work on, and it's also okay that not a lot of people yet find my stream. I still find streaming pretty scary.
Scary people in here.
Yeah. Well, I had on Twitch before that when I just started streaming, there would quite often be like trolls in my chat that would pretend to be donating or would like ask weird questions all of the time. I haven't had that a lot with YouTube. I think on Twitch it's just easy to go to a section and scroll all the way down and find the people that have the least viewers to go and torment them. I think on YouTube that's a little bit more difficult. I'm not sure actually how the YouTube live section shows things.
I don't even know if there is a... Is there a YouTube live section?
There used to be a gaming section. But I don't know if they actually deleted that. I haven't used this brush yet, it's totally fresh. About a couple of new brushes. They're the Raphael soft aqua brushes, and I love them a lot. They're like imitation squirrel, but they're a little bit more like they hold their shape a little bit better than real squirrel hair does.
I see. You have to find it through the explore section, which everyone knows the YouTube explore section is where everyone finds their YouTube videos.
Yeah, it's the best.
Always has the best recommendations for you.
So I think actually the only way that people find my live streams on YouTube is if they get it through their browse function. It's not like if people want to troll in live videos, they will easily find exactly my video. On Twitch, that's a lot easier.
Near, I thought you said YouTube was gonna take over Twitch because you can find streams more easily, like new streams.
Yeah, because of the browse function. And then you subscribe to the people and then you keep getting them, right? But I guess that if you think like, oh, I want to watch an art stream and you don't have anything in your browse function, then it is pretty hard to find. And of course, I don't know how hard YouTube is pushing live streams. I don't know what they're planning.
I had to Google how to find them, so they're not pushing it that hard.
Yeah, definitely. Okay, I'm not into this type of music today, so I think I'm just gonna go to a different section. Maybe... just put on something like this. Not feeling the heavily edited voices that were on those type of songs. Definitely don't have space to keep the proportions the same as the study, so we'll have to squish the Shiba Inu a little bit to fit him in this square. I also want to try to think more about the composition of my sketchbook pages. That I, instead of working randomly, like I mostly do, just working until I'm satisfied with the page, and I think about how the composition fits together. Little bit more planning.
You ever look at someone else's sketchbook and think, they definitely planned this composition?
Yeah. Yeah, quite often actually. A lot of people do like a bunch of small sketches on one page and then one big on big sketch on the other page. Or
big sketch.
They will do like that they divide, let me zoom out a little bit, that they divide the sketchbook where they say like, okay, I want here on this side only these types of sketches, and then under this line I want to do a collage or something. So they'll do things like that, and that's a little bit more planned than just randomly working around. So I thought maybe for this page I want to do study, design, a study, a design, and a study and a design. So it's like a zigzag. But then I have to glue one of the studies over the edge here. So that's going to be maybe a little bit tricky. You can also do like three studies on this page and then three designs glued on this page. Also a possibility. So these paints I'm working with right now are from Aricius Arts on Instagram. And I've used them a couple of times before, and they're actually made to almost work like gouache. She also calls them the gouache-like paints. And she's been working on improving these. I have like the first edition, and she asked me recently if I wanted to try out some of her newer ones. So maybe one day I will get those. Because she's actually working on getting them in paint tubes, so you can work freshly with the paint instead having to reactivate them, which is not ideal for gouache. Because with gouache you sometimes want to get like a very opaque effect with like your thick fresh paint, and if you have to reactivate your gouache then you can not really get that thick effect. Yeah, I think these first ones that I got from her are already pretty good, quite nice to work with. Also, they activate so nicely because sometimes when you have handmade watercolors and you drop some water on the paint, it takes a little while you're rubbing on it to get like the pigment off. As you can see here, I just dropped some water on it and I instantly have a lot of pigment. That's great. And changing the music up a little bit because oh no, the other music was annoying me. Like it was too much of a repetition. This is actually is also a lot of repetition, this playlist. Don't know yet if I like this or if it's like not an effect that I want in my art. Not something I've done before, like just adding background like this. think I'm gonna... put these ones here. And then... maybe I'll use this piece to make a design on too, but this is like a weird rectangular shape, so not sure. We can do like a similar setup for both pages and then do the studies around that. I think that's what we're gonna do. And I'm just gonna glue them in so I don't move them around and I can work around that ID. If I have some glue still. It's my old... the other glue stick that I used actually ran out. But I still have this tube. Of the same brand. I'll have to get some new glue soon. And maybe I'll get a stick instead of a tube. Let me grab this red pencil that I used here.
Meantime, I will work on providing some beverages.
Yeah. So it would be best to have like a sketch here in the corner. The D. And then we'll have two somewhere in the middle. I'm just gonna put some light rectangles. I find that sometimes, like, planning out a composition where you just put down some lines that you have to work in helps to, like, relax and helps with my empty page fear sometimes. Let's see if we can add some lines there. I feel like I'm zooming in and out a lot, but I do think that it's like easier to see what I'm doing when I'm zoomed in than when I'm working on the total of the page. But I'll be a little bit more zoomed out. If it's annoying, just let me know. Want me to keep more on one type of zoom? Try to minimize the zooming. Yeah, I'm trying to add some interest by using some white because, but since I didn't really make a base underneath, the white doesn't show up that much. I'm not sure if this actually does a lot.
I wanna drown inside this. I wanna drown inside this. Go down and I can't. I never had a vibe this vibrant. Them are all so shiny with that three eye vision. Take this moment, I'ma die inside it. I am pariah, I am a riot.
Right, I think that helps a bit. Thank you. Let me look at the next reference picture. We'll work on that. I think actually that I'm gonna work on a different paper and then just glue it in. So I don't have to work here over this edge. And then we'll... it will be like how I glued it in here. We'll have to start using a lot of thin papers on the edge because this sketchbook is getting quite thick. You can already see that it gets quite hard to open it flat. I am using these clips. Helps a bit. And I should have sketchbook here. This one. It has quite thin paper, so it's perfect for what I want to do now. Don't worry about it, it just dropped. Make the case of my ballpoint pen. Tail is not as fluffy as today. My instinct was to draw it, because of course I draw a lot of fluffy tails. This tail is actually quite great.
Bless you.
Thank you. I haven't shown a dog that I'm drawing, right? Working on this one. As you can see, I started out already with a tail that doesn't look anything like this one, but well. That's what I get for not setting up the light lines first. This should be about the right size for me to cut it out and put it in here. It's sort of in the square like this one does. I wonder if when I'm done with this challenge, I will actually see like a lot of improvement in the way that I draw dogs. Because of course I've drawn already a lot of dogs in my life, so maybe the improvement will not be that big.
I think you've drawn a lot of different dogs though, with the challenge.
Yeah. I think it will be mainly like that I experiment with how I approach things creatively. I think that will definitely spice up the way that I draw in general. I don't think I've drawn a lot of dogs where you can see the ribcage. In this one you can actually see the ribcage. Faintly, but you can see it. I've drawn some horses' anatomy in the past. I like practiced how the rib cages of the horse would be, the shoulder muscles and stuff. I have no idea what I'm doing here. Like, I'm sure here is like a muscle group, and we'll have some connections here, but I have no idea how actually the muscles go here. Wanna get really good in drawing extremely if you wanna get really good in drawing like extreme type of muscles that you often see in comic books and such. It probably would be good to look for some anatomy books. That's not really my worry here. We're at the end of this playlist. Just gonna go to my other playlist. Actually, we might put up a folk pop playlist, maybe.
Different.
Yeah. So I put on folk pop, but if this is not what we want to listen to, then I also have indie bangers, which we can listen to.
Ah yes. All music is either of two genres. Folk pop or indie bangers.
Yeah. I've continued a little bit on the class that I'm taking on Domestika, and I really like how she talks about making different lines and playing around, and then she's like, oh yeah, so a lot of people will tell you to make like confident lines in as little strokes as possible, so your drawing will become really clean. And then she's like, oh yeah, but I don't want to make lines like this. Lines like this are boring. I want to make lines like this. That's interesting. And I'm like, wow, that goes so against what I've like learned so far. But it is really fun to play around with like texture of the line. Hey Saskia, welcome to the stream. Thank you for popping in. just like art is always a subject that everyone will disagree on everything you do. I think that's also what makes it intimidating for a lot of people, that they're like, oh, I don't want to draw because I have to do it in this way. And actually, it doesn't matter. You just do what you want to do. I think I want to try, when I'm stylizing this one later, I want to try to make it like really cute, but still skinny, like how this dog is. I actually didn't make it as skinny as the reference. I think the reference it's even more skinny. Maybe I'll give it like a really big eyes. Let's add a little bit of value here. I think that will help a little bit. Instead of using like a gray or black that I've used before, I will just use whatever's on my palette. So it's gonna be this pink. Have you been, Saskia? I saw you were working on your website a little bit back. You finished it? Because you wanted to go and sell stickers online, right? I think she was planning on opening a webshop.
This dog a lot different.
That's what I was really trying to get in the Pinterest board that I made. Like, I wanted some different dogs in there, but I didn't want to make it too different, because if they would be all like extremely different, then I worried that none of the information that I'm getting from drawing a new kind of dog would stick. So there are a couple of these kinds of dogs in there. Hopefully if I draw them a couple of times, like the things I learned from drawing these, I can then use in other drawings. Of course, the only thing to really learn something is repetition. Yeah, I like this playlist. I think we're sticking to the folk pop playlist for now. Maybe we'll do indie bangers next time. This paper of this sketchbook that I just tore out is so interesting because it's like a really thin paper, but it has a sort of interesting texture. It looks like it has little lines over it. You probably can't really see it on stream. I'll try to show it. Finish this. You. I think it's probably like, maybe you can see it a little bit. It's interesting texture. I was thinking that maybe one day I wanna like scan in my sketchbooks and make spells out of them that people can download. But since I've been like really making my sketchbooks interactive, where you can fold out things and paper is sticking out of the page because I glued it in, makes it a little bit more difficult to make a PDF file of it. I think I used too much glue here. Maybe it's okay. Just gonna wait for this one half to dry and then I'll glue on the other half when this is dry. And I think I want to do the creative version of this study here. And we'll actually, I want to put on a layer of paint first. And I think I actually want to stick to the color combination of the three paints that I took out. So the whole page will have like a small color scheme. I think that will be fun. There we go. I think that worked really well. I'm gonna go to the bathroom real quick. Be right back. Where did I leave my be right back? Notes that I had before. There they are. It's a lonely road to travel on. It's a heavy loss to be alone. Now I finally think I found someone. I'm back. It's getting quite dark outside, and I guess it's going to rain soon. I hope that I'll have enough light for me to film. I put away my filming light, it's in the other room. We want to have our house a little bit neat. We'll have visitors tomorrow.
Streaming light is quite big.
Yeah, it's huge. It's in the when it's in the living room, like it's about this big, maybe even a little bit bigger. And then it's of course on a tripod, and just takes up a lot of room. Especially when I also have my camera on a tripod, which is next to it. This is dry. Let's try and do what the lady of my the Domestika course that I'm taking said.
I was very interested to see where the sentence went after. I'm gonna do what my lady. Like, who's this?
My lady.
My lady. You have a lady?
No, I only have a lord.
Would you think it's improper if I refer to you, to other people, as my lady?
No.
You deem it uncouth.
You can call me my lady if you want to.
Right.
And also we bought Tom a lord certificate for his birthday, so he's officially a lord.
Exactly. It's like the new craze after everyone bought stars. Newest craze is buying lord titles.
I think it's actually a lot of people have been doing it for years. It's especially popular on like Celtic festivals and such. Because people all want to be lord and ladies.
They're all in Scotland, right?
Yeah, most of them, or in Ireland.
Yeah.
I know I said I wanted to make this one cute. I don't know if this is a cute face. Next time I will put in the title Featured Lord Tom.
Yikes.
So they know you're here.
I wanted to come for you, not for my my money.
This is an interesting stylization so far. I don't think I really made the lines that interesting. They look pretty smooth. Not what we learned. Let's make it messy.
Understand it all, it's me that I-
So when I make a thumbnail for the next live stream, I often make like a picture of the thing that I did in the last live stream. Should I change my thumbnails after I'm done with the stream?
To better reflect what's in the video?
Yeah.
Maybe. Can imagine you see the thumbnail and you're like, oh, that looks cool, I want to watch that, and then it's something else.
Yeah.
Doesn't YouTube like auto-generate thumbnails?
Yeah, like, but the auto-generated thumbnails are always ugly, right? Plus you cannot add text on the automated thumbnails. I wanna say on the... I think this thumbnail says like... drawing dogs in my sketchbook or something. If you watch a YouTube video about how to grow on YouTube, the first thing they will always say is make good thumbnails.
Yeah. I guess it is pretty important.
Yeah, right?
So you might want to change it.
So the wind that stroked your hair, left your scent in the air, and the sun was almost acting as a spotlight just for you, making flowers bloom. Days are made for you. You make me weak in the knees. I'm doubly leaving you and me. So darling, please fly away with me, and you will see. Away before I could say that all I want is you and to be near, standing where you are. I'll give you my heart, peace when we're apart. But then he walked by, you see, he walked by and started to smile. Got up and took him by the hand. Now I understand that he is your man. You make me.
His song has a storyline. I'm gonna try to line this with a brush. I think I'm gonna use this ink for it. Not sure if it like will fit color wise, but it's the ink that I have on my desk, so I'm gonna use it. And it's often how it goes, whatever is on my desk gets used. Well, the other things get forgotten.
Or back shelf paints.
Yeah, that's why I sometimes put everything away and get some things out of my closet. So they'll get used. We'll have to remember to mess up the lines on purpose.
So bring your A game, 'cause you know. stop. We can never run out of time, sipping strawberry lime. You know I wanna share it with you, share it with you, share it with you. Hey baby, if you're looking for some crazy, I'll tell you everybody's standing in the line for the water slide. You can come on over, we can take the roller coaster.
See what else I want to do with this. Getting quite windy out. It's actually raining now. Yeah.
Cooling off now.
Let's hope it's dry tonight, so we don't have to bike in the rain. I'm quite happy with this one. I'm not sure about the green undertone for the body, but okay. Something else. And it fits in the color scheme of what the page is going to be.
I could not have told you that that was green.
Do you think this is green? Do you think this is green, what I'm showing on screen?
Well, I have to wait for the stream to catch up.
Is it actually a little bit behind? It should be quite... like, without the delay.
It looks like ocean. Green color.
I think it's kind of a mint color.
Yeah. Like mint ice cream.
Let's see what's next. Yeah, we're gonna work on a nice derpy one. Gonna work on this one. Picture cutie. It's not that clear where his paws go. It looks like he's being held up by someone.
Yeah,
So I think I'm gonna focus on the face mostly and try to not include the pulse too much. Yeah, it is a mint color.
Feathers in my hair and braids around my waist. I'm almost a bird. These mountain views, pink sunsets got me.
Try and get it big enough. This is about a square, and that's working. That gonna put my sketchbook a little bit out of the way. I put it here, I can show it a little bit on screen, but it won't bother me too much while drawing. Actually quite hard to get this right.
I'm so happy to see you. And we learn from our mistakes. And we grow from what breaks us. We let it take its time. We long for
I don't think I have a lot of dogs with like these hanging ears in the Pinterest board.
This love has never been stronger. I'm up in the clouds when you're not, it's getting much harder, and I'm falling down, down, I'm falling down. I see your face on all of the pages, in the scrapbook of my mind. To put it down for a while takes ages, then I'm falling down, down.
What's really nice is when I'm streaming, I can actually just look at my screen and see a nice overview of the picture that I'm drawing. And then I have the reference right next to it, so I can compare how the proportions look. And that's something that's like, unless I hold it up next to it, it's not something that I normally see. Interesting. I think the eye is this eye is placed a little bit off. The picture of this dog is so cute and I feel like I'm ruining it. It's not that bad. It's okay. Definitely not as cute as the picture. That's the biggest frustration in drawing animals, is your drawings are not as cute as the animal itself.
And start drawing animals that aren't cute.
Yeah, that helps. Which is the least cute animal out there. There probably are some really ugly animals.
Yeah, like those bats.
bats
that look like they're terrified.
Then I'll be at your door.
Or the monkeys with the giant eyes. They got...
Also a lot of like insects and stuff, right? It can be cool, but they're not exactly like the cutest animals out there. Was looking at because I was doing some research of about Leishmania, the I don't know what's it called in English, probably something similar, the dog disease that they get from like little flies in southern Europe, and was looking at these fleas and they're like really fluffy, the wings are fluffy, and I was like, if they didn't sting, because they're if they just were like harmless fleas, they flies, they would be like so cute. But now they're like quite terrifying because they jump around and bite you. That's not cute. They make your dog sick for the rest of his life. It's actually something I didn't even think about, that if you go on vacation with your dog to just southern Europe, if your dog was from the Netherlands, then they have never encountered that, right? Never encountered that disease. Quite scary to think about. But the site was saying that because of global warming, we probably will have those fleas here soon too.
I see.
So that sucks. They're actually a type of mosquitoes, not fleas. But the close-up picture of the mosquito was really cute. pretty cute mosquito.
Yeah, it's interesting. When I look deep into your
eyes. Let me see. Okay, I cannot see a picture where it's not terrifying. Never mind. No one is show the picture where he's biting a dog. I think. Also draw the whiskers. Although I know that's gonna make him even less cute, the drawing, but we're doing a study, so we might as well try to make it accurate.
Trying to deny that we should be together.
together. We only need the two of us together. We only need the two of us together. We only need the two of us together. Cause we got love.
I think I'm gonna make the cushion that he's sitting against a different color to make it clear. Quite a lot of work for the study. Go this far and stop here. My allergy season is starting.
Is it worse now that it's rained?
It's usually better when it's rained, when it has rained. Because when it hasn't rained, like all the things are flowing in the air. And when it's raining, they get out of the air. Rain down to the ground. I'm gonna do this one in the little one here up. It's only a face, that will be a little bit easier to stylize it there. I'm so slow today, we've been streaming already for quite a while. Otherwise I can just like stop the stream and finish the last one tonight. Have to see.
as long as the stars are shining above us, then I just wanna be where you are. I don't wanna close my eyes, then I might miss a moment of you. And as long as the sun shines upon us, and I just wanna be where you are. 'Cause with you I feel no fear, and when you hold me, all my wounds.
Can also just hurry up and make some more stylized simple designs. I think that's also like the interesting thing about this challenge, that you sometimes will get forced to make some choices. I think it's faster. See. Oh, I'm entirely not working on the page anymore, on the screen anymore. I don't know how much you guys have seen me doing the sketch here.
How come the sky sometimes hides behind the clouds? Maybe it's just like me, a little bit scared of heights. Why does the rain always keep on pouring down when it's gray outside? It really makes me wonder. Yeah, it makes me wonder. It really makes me wonder. Ooh, I wonder. Untrust when it's cold, and don't they miss the leaves they left behind? Could it be to make the ground shine like gold until winter comes? Until winter comes? Until winter comes? It really makes me wonder.
What a derper.
I quite like this little sketch. I think I'm just gonna leave this one like this, and while it's drying, I'm going to the bathroom real quick. Show us where we are. It really makes me wonder. Yeah, it makes me wonder. Ooh, I wonder. I just wonder. It really makes me wonder.
Some people have written books, some have a great look that covers the magazines for kids who are 17. But I don't know what to do, staring into the blue sky and just waiting for a sign. Some, they are certain of what awaits them when it all ends. But I don't know what will happen to me. Will I be remembered in this century? Talk of the town that we are living in. Well, I don't know. I don't know. How could I know what lies ahead of me? Am I part of a grander master plan? Will I be washed away like lights in the sand? Some people that put their faith into someone who's half their age, reading from a torn out page from a book filled with lies. But I don't know what to do. I'm staring into the blue sky and just waiting for a sign.
Right, I'm back.
Certain of what awaits them when it all ends.
Let's start on the last study that we have to do today. And I think this page is starting to look quite cohesive. This is definitely a more planned page than the last one.
we are living in.
I don't know what will happen to me. Will I be remembered in this century? Or will I be forgotten? Yeah. Like dust in
we actually have another face. We'll be doing this one.
From kind of turn me upside down. I just don't know what to do. I want to spend the night at
hers and bring on one of my t-shirts. Should so it smells like move that line a little bit down. I don't think we'll have enough space to work that far up.
Ever been in love? Have you ever lost your head? Have you felt like you were out of breath when you saw her in that dress? When your heart is beating fast and you're sweating and you can't stop looking at her smile, then you've been in love. That's how you know you've been in love. There's something about the way she laughs and the way she always dances when she thinks nobody sees. And when she's gonna miss her so, I tell her, baby, please don't go. I think you should stay with me. And I really get what the love songs are talking about. Oh, and I just wanna tell her how I feel, scream it out loud. Have you ever been in love? Have you ever lost your head? Have you felt like you were out of breath when you saw her in that dress? When your heart is beating fast and you're sweating, you can't stop looking at her smile. Then you've been in love. That's how you know you've been in love.
In a little bit more.
Right now the outline looks like Paddington Bear.
Guess it kind of does.
Stay, yeah, stay. And through the dark and cold,
This summer yet has like a little bit of pink fur next to its eye. Like it's wearing eyeshadow. As my drawing looks more like a beard than like a summer yet.
For now.
Not sure I mean, can.
Does it look more like a bear? It looks more like a drawn bear.
I guess. My pen is starting to hold up to annoy me again, but I almost have this finished, so work a little longer. To add some more lines here, but light lines, but the pen doesn't want to work anymore, so just add some darker lines and pray that it looks looks okay. I think it just looks messy now. I'll do the rest with paint.
You're the rose in the garden.
think it looks quite okay now. At least the face of the Samoyed. Don't really like the head, but that's okay.
Go outside, the snow is falling down, and every child is having so much fun. The snowman is twice the size as me, with a smile as quirky as mine. We're holding hands to keep each other warm while we stand and watch a choir perform, and all the Christmas songs that we love. Yeah, all the Christmas songs that we love. And in a while, we're gonna go inside and drink our chocolate by the fire. Cause all I want is to spend this day with you. Let me give you a Christmas, a moment we'll fill with love and joy.
This is Christmas music.
Thanks for the play.
Right, I'll do one more design based on this cute Samoyed, and we're done. So what will I do? I think I'm gonna paint a little background first. I'll make it a really light pink, I think. Wait for it to dry a little bit. I think I'm gonna do the lines again in this pencil. Not sure what we'll do after it. Yeah, I'll actually try working in this while it's still wet. Could be interesting.
felt as good or as easy as when we were young. Oh, oh, oh. Though I felt misunderstood, it was a pleasure running away with you. We were just children acting like a doll, crazy, naive, bold and carefree. We were kids having kids.
I think it wasn't clear where I was drawing.
You have to move around the camera a lot during such a picture.
Now they keep us on speaking terms. We grow and we learn.
I'm also just getting a bit tired, so my focus is not that high anymore. Not thinking about things are on screen or not.
When the timing's right, there's no wasteland.
Been streaming for a long time. I wanna finish this so I can take a little break. Use some of that blue in the background. More Christmas.
Get the wine and the corkscrew.
I'm gonna use a little bit of white in the blue so it's a bit more opaque. I think I'm gonna use this pen for the lines. That'd be interesting. Not sure if I like this one or not. Definitely the paint still needs to dry. think I'm gonna leave it like this. Right? And that's what we had to do for today. At least that's what I had to do for today.
That was
my little challenge.
That was a nice pitch.
Yeah, I like how they turn out. Actually, I still need to number them. Because I wanna. Stopped at 20 yesterday, so I have. And as long as we're together, 21. It doesn't matter where we are. 2, 23. I only number the studies, I don't place numbers next to the designs. Yeah, I'm really happy with how it turned out. It's a bit more organized than the other ones. It looks nice as a spread. I don't think they're my best drawings, but they look nice together, and also was good to work with like a different color scheme than I usually use. Right, I think I'll have time to stream tomorrow, right? I definitely have to do a lot for the shop update on Wednesday.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I'm gonna have to do these drawings anyways. So, might as well stream them. Yeah. I'll probably be back tomorrow. I'm not sure what time, but it will be somewhere in the afternoon, so around 2 or 3, probably. So I try to get a little thing up on YouTube so you can see it a couple of hours before. And I'm still quite happy working on this challenge, and we're actually almost at half of it. And, I'm gonna try soon to see if I can work a little bit ahead, because we'll have some busy weeks to come.
Me. I mean, you're at home with the dog, you can probably find time to draw, right?
Yeah.
Not time to stream, maybe. But
yeah, can find time to draw, but I don't know. There's a lot of distractions and stuff.
Yeah.
We'll have to see. Anyways, I'm gonna end the stream. I hope to see you guys in the next stream, which will be tomorrow. And if you like the stream, then be sure to subscribe to my channel and like it, because that definitely helps a lot. And yeah, I hope to see you guys in the next one. Bye bye.
Later.